Good evening and welcome to tonight's broadcast of Lakeside Junior High Boys versus the Magnolia Panthers. Will, tonight is a big game for Lakeside because Lakeside needs to they need to win, because if they win, they get the one seed in the district tournament, which is here at Lakeside, of course. They need a huge win here tonight. Will, what do you think Lakeside needs to do to win this game?
So the three keys for Lakeside to get this victory is their offense. Dylan, they struggled last time on the offense very bad. Like, they just need to have more confidence, just have to have way more confidence shooting the ball and hit their free throws, because if they hit their three free throws, then they probably win that game against Sheridan last time we did this. And dominate the paint, get rebounds, clear the boards, and Lakeside comes out with a victory.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, huge game. I can't say it enough.
Yes.
I mean,
this is for the number one seed right here. So Lakeside and Magnolia are going to be playing their hearts out this game.
And I mean, I'm telling you, Magnolia looks really good. But I mean, it's big for Lakeside to not get discouraged. They look like a great squad. But Lakeside's got this for sure. I mean,
hopefully, if they win this, they can execute the first round bye, unlike the Ravens.
Yeah, but don't lose in the championship game, you know.
And another guard, number 15, Avery McBride.
Avery McBride played great defense, great hustle last matchup we had in Sheridan.
Jackson Clifford. And another forward, number 14, Bentley Gidrin.
Big time three shooter. Deadly from the arc.
Looks like Jackson Ford, the new starter, leading the Rams offense, it seems like. She can shoot very well to get boards, and I think that's a great...
Yeah, it was a great start. Jackson is tall. He's got great range, and I think they should use that a lot to start this game. They have to start scoring fast, I feel.
Yeah.
Magnolia is the other best team in the conference. They go hand in hand. So, besides Little Rock Christian,
and
they just need to go hand in hand. They have to start quick.
Yeah, by far.
Almost away from opening tip-off. Tip-off goes to Magnolia to start. Avery McBride, good defense off the slot. And a good drive. Oh! Missed off the side. Number 10's got it. Kick out, spin, drive again, and foul and one
by Magnolia. Great play by Magnolia, getting the rebound after the miss.
Big time. Offensive rebounds is everything in this game. First free throw, it's off. And Magnolia almost gets the rebound, and it'll be off of Magnolia.
Great Inbound. Start by Magnolia so far. Could have been better if they got a three-point lead.
It would have been big for them, because now here comes Q Jackson. Bentley. Whoa.
Kind of looked low.
Deflected. Back to Axel. Q's got it. Bentley to Axel. Lakeside, a little slow.
It's Magnolia defense playing amazing right now.
Everyone touching the ball this possession.
By far.
Q to Axel. Axel driving, kicks it out to Avery. If you're not familiar with the rules of ninth grade, it's a no shot clock, so Lakeside can hold the ball as long as they want.
Oh.
And a foul.
Great rebound by Q, but just really couldn't execute on the layup right there. Needs to get that right there.
Yeah, and that'll be the first foul on Lakeside. Second foul, my fault. Pass over cue all over it. Hits it around. Axel jumping. 10-1. Good drive. Up and in. 4-0.
Great little floater.
It's 4-0 Magnolia. Axel goes around cue screen to Bentley. Over to Jackson Ford. Q with a good
roll
spin.
In.
Looking for Avery. Did not find him. And, oh, just off.
This Lakeside offense got figured out. It seems like they just keep passing to one another, and they can't figure out. Like, Magnolia's just playing great defense right now.
Good shot. Off. Good rebound by number 5. Kick out. Oh, air ball.
Air ball.
And it'll be a travel.
Travel.
That's really good for Lakeside.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure Magnolia doesn't score again. Kick it out to 6 points.
And Lakeside needs to score right here so they can set the tone immediately.
Well, it looks like to me Lakeside's plays just aren't getting to where they need to be. The screens aren't working as well as it should be. There's another look at it. Q sets the screen. There was a good switch. Bentley with the ball to Axel. Axel drives, kicks to Jackson Ford for three. Bang! What a shot by Jackson.
Skadoosh!
Kick out. And it's stolen by Avery.
Great
Avery
deflection!
Grabs it again. And a drive, pump fake, and it's in.
And Lakeside has figured it out. Great deflection by Avery McBride, and a little pump fake, acting like he was going for a layup, but got that Magnolia player.
Set him flying right by. Pass
picked
and it's
off again.
Taken by Q. Q and oh, it's a foul on Q. A push.
Ooh.
Crowd does not like it. In comes Emerson Collins for Avery.
Magnolia needs to stop throwing these balls over the three-point line. It just keeps getting picked off. But
ah, there. See, that's how you get it over. You got to lob it.
Mm-hmm.
Good defense by Emerson, coming in with a little bit of energy. And a three off the mark. Rebound by Collins.
Emerson Collins coming off the bench for Avery McBride.
Collins rolls. Good pass to Bentley, and
great look.
What a
by Emerson Collins.
Great pass by Emerson Collins. 7-4 Lakeside. Bench getting into it, and it is knocked out. Whose ball? It'll be
Emerson swats that ball away.
It'll be. They're having a little bit of a discussion on whose it is.
I think, is it Lakeside's ball?
And they're going to call a jump.
Lakeside's ball.
They couldn't see it. So since Magnolia got the opening tip-off, Lakeside will get this jump ball.
And Dylan, Lakeside is clearly entering on offense. A little slow start at the beginning, their first two possessions on offense, but they have figured it out, obviously.
Good screen set by Jackson. Axel. To Collins. Collins, good drive and foul.
Great job by Emerson Collins trying to get a bucket or go to the line. You just love to see it.
Good sportsmanship by Magnolia side, helping Emerson up. 7-4 Lakeside lead. Emerson has a chance to make it 9-4. First shot for Emerson is up and off.
Like I said, Dylan, at the beginning for the three keys, got to hit these. That's Lakeside, one of Lakeside's Achilles right there. Got to hit these free throws. So in late game, if it gets close, which this game probably will be, it can kill them.
Second free throw by Emerson is good. 1-for-2 from the line, and Lakeside goes up by 4. One's better than none, of course. The pass is number 20. Barely gets it over Jackson.
Great bounce pass by Magnolia.
Emerson setting the play up. Good screen by Jackson. The roll was not there.
Ooh.
Bentley, good pump fake.
Great
good drive
pump
by
fake.
Axel. Axel floater, no good. Tipped up and caught by
Axel. Almost gets a rebound there. Would have been huge for Lakeside.
Magnolia going fast pace. Trying to get a bucket here.
Ooh, a little Euro.
Just off and tip back in by number five.
Man.
Now we are tied at 8. Q to Jackson. Back to Q. Q with the drive.
So that's a drive.
It'll be on the floor against Magnolia. That would be Magnolia's second foul.
See if Lakeside can get a little open three right here to either Jackson or Bentley.
Good screen by Q. Jackson picked
great
out.
Look.
It was in the Bentley.
Ooh,
Collins
Q.
To Q, just off.
That was a great shot by Q, wide open. Defender wasn't really closing up on him. I like that.
It was definitely a great look. Pass to 20. Good drive in, stripped by Jackson, grabbed by Q.
Ooh!
Good pass up to Bentley, no foul called. It'll be white ball. Wow.
Man, that throw and catch kind of looked like Brady and Edelman back in the early days of football.
Wow. It was different. There could have been a foul.
Yeah.
Maybe a makeup by the ref to give Lakeside the ball. And
one! Love to see it.
Good play by Q.
Q needs to hit this free throw. Be amazing. Just be.
Great play.
Yeah.
So this was Q's Achilles heel
by far
when they played Sheridan.
Mm-hmm.
Could not hit the free throws. Will he hit it here? Still not.
Mm.
Just off. And that'll be the end of the first quarter. Lakeside 10, Magnolia 8.
Great start by Lakeside so far, Dylan. Just love the aggression on defense and just they figured out their way on offense clearly.
Oh, yeah, it was a great offensive quarter by Lakeside. Jackson had a big three. Q had a good layup. I mean, it was just all around, everyone did something.
Yeah.
You know? And I think Lakeside was down 4-0 early, but they started finding it, and then they ended up with those two steals that were massive towards the game.
Lakeside coming back-to-back wins against El Dorado and Hot Springs, and hopefully they can get three-piece right here.
Oh, yeah.
Love to see that. Heading.
Well, we would like to give a big thank you to Final Touch Roofing for our game sponsor tonight. They were in business since 2001. Final Touch Roofing, Inc. pledges to provide you with excellent shingle, metal, flat, and stone-coated steel roofing installation and service at fair prices. They provide free detailed roofing estimates on the same day in most instances. All roofing installations come with a 5-year warranty, and they also assist with manufacturer's warranties.
Let's see if Magnolia can answer right here back on offense.
What a down by two. All they need is a nice drive like they've had most of the game. Good lob pass over to number three. That's how they get out of the steals.
Lakeside just playing aggressive right here, double teaming.
Outside. Good pass. Number four.
Ooh.
Spin. Kick out. Looking for the three, could not find it. He gets a two to go.
Great move. A little hop step action right there. Love to see it.
It was a great, great play. Avery's back in. Ford is out. McBride with the ball. He's looking for, he had an open shot, did not take. Gigrich to Avery.
Great
what
look.
A pass. For three off, just off from Collins.
It's a great look by Avery McBride, playing up the defense. Oh, Magnolia just killed.
The whole team was there, and it'll be a jump ball.
Magnolia just keeps throwing these moon balls, and he was clearly double-teamed and then triple-covered.
Possession arrow is with Lakeside, so they will get this jump ball. Collins bringing up the ball to McBride. Good pass to McHugh, and three.
This Lakeside passing right now, prestige. Love to see it.
Love it. There's no stopping Q once he's wide open like that under the rim. Wow. And good play by Bentley to get the steal. Avery holding on to the ball. Kicks it to Collins. And Lakeside back on offense. The drive for Collins. Tipped up in the air. Bentley grabs it. Picks up the dribble. We'll have to give it up to Collins. Axel with the ball. Gigrich.
Collins. The Rams looking for something right here.
Q to Gigrich. Ooh. He had him. Just a little off.
Mm-hmm.
Pass to Q. They don't got to do anything here. They can hold the ball as long as they want.
By far. No shot clock, yeah. Just take your time.
To Q. Q to Bentley. Oh, Bentley almost lost it. Grabs it back.
Magnolia defense playing locks right now.
Oh, almost stolen. Bentley grabs it back. He's looking, picks up his dribble, finds Collins. Someone's got to get a shot off, and then McHugh will.
Man, Lakeside was just playing hot potato right there. Couldn't get any open shots or anything.
That's why you do those drills in practice where everyone has to touch the ball before you shoot the ball.
That was still great defense by Magnolia, though, in that situation.
And a five-second violation on Magnolia. It'll be Lakeside's ball. Axe will take it up for the Rams. Q with a drive, kick out to Bentley. Did not gather, and he'll travel.
So Magnolia offense has to answer right here to stay in this game because Lakeside just picking them apart on offense.
Yeah, Lakeside had a chance to put this into a 6-point game.
Oh!
And now Avery grabs the steal.
Oh.
And he'll give it right back.
Man, Avery on defense just read that like a book. Love to see it.
Avery almost got another one.
Yeah.
And a three. Just off the mark. Saved. Q will grab it. Q.
Oh, Q just using his speed right here.
Lost his dribble. He drives again. And wow. Ooh. Hit to the ground. No foul. Magnolia will continue with the ball. And almost got it again by Lakeside.
Ooh.
He jumped. He went, started in Hot Springs, landed where you think?
Like Hamilton.
Yeah, like Hamilton, Malvern. Oh, good lob to Q and knocked out of bounds by number three.
Looks like Jackson Ford's going to sub in for Q Jackson, give him a little breather.
I mean, Jackson's almost got Q's height, so I could see him being the big for now. Mm-hmm. Pass out
deep
to Bentley
three.
For three.
Yeah! Hey, deep three by Bentley Gigrich. Bum, bullseye.
Gotta love it. Oh, good defense.
Good pass.
No free buckets and foul by Jackson.
Looks like Magnolia is going to go to the line here. A little limp.
No easy buckets.
No. Mm-mm. Magnolia needs first to hit these.
First free throw off. The second one is in. 1 for 2 from the line for Magnolia. 17 to 11. Avery passed to Q. Q bodies and
one. 2-1's by Q Jackson. Now, this is Q's Achilles. We've already said that, but he needs to hit this.
Has to hit
this. Be huge.
Q.
It's like Magnolia.
And here's a sub by Magnolia. Q's free throw is off and rebounded by Bentley. And it'll be hit out of bounds and Lakeside ball.
Bentley playing smart right there. Decided just let go. It was going
to
be there.
Need to touch it after
it
ricochets off someone else. Axel to Q. Q to Collins.
Could be
Axel
a 4
in the
point
corner.
Play by Lakeside
gives
right here.
To Emerson. Q is bodying number 20 down low. Decides to come up and give him a screen. Bentley looking for another three. And it'll be a foul on Avery for a block.
It just looked like Dylan, they're just way too close together. It kind of looked like a failed handoff. It was just.
I don't think that the transition from Bentley to Avery was clean enough. You know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Magnolia needs to get.
And sealed by Avery.
Another one.
Has Axel, and it's it.
Love to see the true eighth year Axel Jansky do that, man. And Avery's just hacking away all those balls that come near him. You just love to see it.
Great job by Avery, and there will be a timeout for Magnolia. Great quarter for Lakeside so far. They're up by 10. Man, how the times changed over the from the start of the game towards now. It's been a good job for Lakeside.
Mm-hmm. We'd like to thank Final Touch Roofing, Wellness Clinic, Alliance Bank, and Park College
for being a great sponsor for Lakeside so far this basketball season. Be sure to tune in to tomorrow night's high school game between your Lakeside Rams and the Pine Bluff Zebras. Big game for Lakeside. I say they can only lose one of their home games coming up.
Magnolia down by 10 right now. Needs to start something on offense.
Hey, I'm looking at Magnolia. I'm seeing like a haircut that like everyone's rocking.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
It's a little bit like John Morant type of haircut, you know. It'll be a turnover by Magnolia. Q driving down the floor.
It'll be a charge on Q. Great to see a charge happen in junior high basketball. You hardly really even see it in high school. Just love to see it in junior high.
Good job by the Magnolia defender. Get his feet set. Let Q go straight through him.
It's like,
and in comes Ashton Herndon. It appears to me that Jackson's in foul trouble, and so is Q now. So Ashton comes in. And they're going to go straight at him.
I think
it'll be a charge.
Back-to-back charges.
Wow.
Emerson said, I'm going to need one of those two. And
well, again, just an amazing job.
It's like Magnolia's pressing.
There. And now Emerson off the press. It'll be, and did he step out?
I think he might have went a little too fast. Still can't really catch his dribble that time.
Yeah, they had 36 seconds. If I'm them, I'm sitting, waiting, getting the shot. But now Magnolia has a chance to do just that. Oh, tries to dribble around him, and he'll travel.
Oh!
You should bring a passport with you.
I know.
Trip around the world.
Like Apollo 13 out there. Looks like. Spot's wet right there. Coach Ward coming in clutch with the towels right here.
And the grip is not good over there, so. Axel finds Bentley. James with the ball. He's also a new sub. James trapped. Does not find him.
Magnolia needs her score right here.
And a foul.
No clue what the tech was for. I didn't really.
I mean, he had a foul. Was there something I admit? Was there something said? The tech was on the player, not the coach.
Coach Bear, chill out before he gets a tech.
And Axel just off the rim. Did not like him there.
Oh, some of it's getting heated.
Now we've got, Magnolia parents are up. They're a little frustrated. They got the shooter lineup in for Lakeside.
Oh, Carson steals it from Emerson.
It gets tipped up in the air. Emerson cannot grab it. Number three gets a chance.
Off the top of the hoop.
I mean, and it'll be halftime.
And, man, Magnolia just needs to figure something out right now. They clearly can't do anything on the offense. Lakeside just playing straight-up clamps.
22-11 will be your halftime. The coach is not excited about the half. Hands on his head. He's still talking to the ref about the technical.
Some of the parents are still mad at the refs, too, screaming. This is still going on right here.
This is very interesting.
Are you ready to feel like a rock star? We offer injections to reverse signs of aging, unheard of weight loss results with our semaglutide compound, M-Sculpt for incredible muscle tone in your abs, and hormone balancing pellets to get you back in the saddle. Call us for a free consultation at Rockstar Wellness Clinic.
Whoever you rally or root for, Reliance Bank is your biggest fan. Our customers always take the center spot with easy online and mobile banking. No lines, no waiting, and no second place customers. When the rules changed, we changed our game with more ways than ever to access your account. Everyone comes in first. A local bank with a modern approach. Reliance Bank. Open an account online now at rely.bank.
There's a place for you at National Park College. NPC understands that one size doesn't fit all, and everyone deserves an opportunity to find their place. Flexible class options, in person and online, help you set the schedule you need at about half the cost of the average Arkansas university. National Park College offers a supportive college experience, close to home at about half the cost. Schedule a tour or apply today. Learn more at np.edu.
Lakeside TV is a student-run broadcast program where dozens of students get the opportunity to produce live events. They can get hands-on experience creating graphics, videos, and commercials for Lakeside Athletics. They get the opportunity to get creative while learning Adobe Photoshop, Premiere Pro, and After Effects. Lakeside TV live streams a wide range of events from football to basketball to graduation. You can find all of our content on our YouTube page, Lakeside TV.
Are you ready to feel like a rock star? We offer injections to reverse signs of aging, unheard of weight loss results with our semaglutide compound, M-Sculpt for incredible muscle tone in your abs, and hormone balancing pellets to get you back in the saddle. Call us for a free consultation at Rockstar Wellness Clinic.
Whoever you rally or root for, Reliance Bank is your biggest fan. Our customers always take the center spot with easy online and mobile banking. No lines, no waiting, and no second place customers. When the rules changed, we changed our game with more ways than ever to access your account. Everyone comes in first. A local bank with a modern approach. Reliance Bank.
Open an account online now at rely.bank.
There's a place for you at National Park College. NPC understands that one size doesn't fit all, and everyone deserves an opportunity to find their place. Flexible class options, in-person and online, help you set the schedule you need at about half the cost of the average Arkansas university. National Park College offers a supportive college experience, close to home at about half the cost. Schedule a tour or apply today. Learn more at np.edu.
Lakeside TV is a student-run broadcast program where dozens of students get the opportunity to produce live events. They can get hands-on experience creating graphics, videos, and commercials for Lakeside Athletics. They get the opportunity to get creative while learning Adobe Photoshop, Premiere Pro, and After Effects. Lakeside TV live streams a wide range of events from football to basketball to graduation. You can find all of our content on our YouTube page, Lakeside TV.
Are you ready to feel like a rock star? We offer injections to reverse signs of aging, unheard-of weight loss results with our semaglutide compound, M-Sculpt for incredible muscle tone in your abs, and hormone-balancing pellets to get you back in the saddle. Call us for a free consultation at Rockstar Wellness Clinic.
Whoever you rally your root for, Reliance Bank is your biggest fan. Our customers always take the center spot with easy online and mobile banking. No lines, no waiting, and no second place customers. When the rules changed, we changed our game with more ways than ever to access your account. Everyone comes in first. A local bank with a modern approach. Reliance Bank. Open an account online now at rely.bank.
There's a place for you at National Park College. NPC understands that one size doesn't fit all, and everyone deserves an opportunity to find their place. Flexible class options, in-person and online, help you set the schedule you need at about half the cost of the average Arkansas university. National Park College offers a supportive college experience, close to home at about half the cost. Schedule a tour or apply today. Learn more at np.edu.
Lakeside TV is a student-run broadcast program where dozens of students get the opportunity to produce live events.
We are back, and another thank you to Final Touch Roofing for Final Touch Roofing for just being a part with us and stuff. And if you ever need a new roof, you know who to call. And Dylan?
Well, here we go.
Magnolia needs to answer right here.
Magnolia's down 11. Drive up. No good. Rebound forward. Avery to Axel. Axel with a little fake. They're taking too long in the backcourt. And a timeout for Coach. Wow.
Wow. This Lakeside's defense just came out just saying, we're not going to let you score anymore. We're coming for you.
Good start for Lakeside. But good start for Magnolia as well. Wow. Out of the play, mm-hmm. They got trapped them. Ugh. Coming out of the timeout, Lakeside's looking to find it after almost getting a 10-second back in the backcourt. And the inbound to Axel.
Looks like Magnolia is still continuing to press.
And they got it over.
It looks like.
Wow. Just over.
Jackson looked a little confused. He thought maybe like someone was like over there. He was like, is that ball to me?
Yeah, right. Just a little bit over Jackson. Q was a little frustrated after the play. And just off, and the shot, everyone's on the ground, and it'll be jump ball.
Jump ball, I think.
Jump ball is Lakeside's ball. And a sub for Jackson. No, yes.
It looks like these Magnolia parents are still a little iffy about the refs.
Tad bit.
Before half, if you missed it, they were just screaming at the refs and stuff. And
good job by Avery. They don't have time for this. And it'll be a 10-second violation on Lakeside. There was a threat on their first possession, and now it happened.
It just seems like the whistle just keeps constantly blowing. I'm like,
yeah, it was just a bad inbound play. I mean, I don't know. The drive by three. Ooh. Oh, just off cue. Look at the drive.
A little too hard on the
pass. And, just off. Good pass up to three. Three
Bentley
with the drive on Bentley. A foul.
I think that's great on Bentley's side. Basically, 2-on-1 fast break. Couldn't really do anything in that situation. I think he did perfectly fine.
Best thing you do is set a struggling free throw team to the free throw line.
Foul, man.
The first free throw is off. The second is up and no good. Bentley
Another
almost with the rebound. Oh my gosh. Magnolia gets it. Ooh. And the floater's good. And
makes
here we go again with the press.
Makes up for his two missed free throws.
They're taking too long. And actually
barely
gets it off. And it'll be a foul on.
Collision right there.
Magnolia.
Yeah, at that point, Axel didn't care who was in this way. He was like, get out of my way.
Yeah, Axel was ready to run through anybody.
Look how fast he was going, yeah. It's like he's tying his shoe.
Axel tied the shoe. And here we go. Q to Collins. Q at the top of the key still. Avery looking for a shot. Did not find one. Bentley moving. Axel with the ball to Q again. Drive. And a
Axel
shot from Axel. It is good.
Skadoosh.
What a shot by Axel Jasty.
And Lakeside, they're hot tonight for threes by far.
And, a foul.
Ooh. Axel.
Everyone scrambling for that ball. It was a foul on, I believe, it was on Avery. That was his third. That's not good for Avery.
Mm-mm. Yeah, this Lakeside team needs to tone the aggressiveness a little bit because soon they're going to have to be subbing in some of their backups.
And the pass number zero, good drive, and a foul on the floor. That would be what I believe foul number three on Lakeside. Magnolia's already two fouls off bonus. He's got zero in the corner. You did not see him. Oh, now he passes it to him. And a foul on the floor. Oh, not another on Avery.
Avery has four now.
That's his fourth foul.
Like I said, the whistle just keeps constantly blowing.
We'll be here all night.
Yeah, possibly.
Oh, he did not know the pass was coming. He didn't get the ball.
Lakeside just
and the pass to the corner for three. Just off. And they somehow get the offensive rebound.
Man, Lakeside really wants that
number
ball.
Number five gets the ball. Oh, just off. Q has it.
Oh.
Body's flying. Pass intercepted. And he makes the shot. Now down by 10. That was the that was a very wild
great
possession.
Pass.
And wow. Great assist by Q. Good finish by Bentley. So a 12-point game. Avery gets the ball.
Man,
here
Avery.
Here we go again. Action to Avery. Avery to Emerson.
Ooh, Emerson was thinking about that.
He was looking for it. Axel, foul. And there's another whistle for you.
Yep.
And out will come Slide. Avery.
Carson's going to get subbed in.
Man. That's also the fifth foul on number one. He is now fouled out.
Man. Magnolia players are running out of players.
Well, Lakeside has foul trouble, but so does now Magnolia. It seems to only have a five-man rotation. I mean, a six-man rotation, so now it's down to five. Q. Emerson. Moving around. Q's looking. He finds Axel. Axel moving around. He gets Q.
Great
Q
look.
Is fouled.
See if Q can hit these.
Number five was not happy with the call. He thought he got a clean block. The coach, hands on his head, not very happy also. Q with his first free throw made.
Yeah, I think the Magnolia coach was by far expecting something different, a little tighter game. Maybe Magnolia a little bit more domination on the court tonight.
Yeah, I just think fouls are a killer. And, just off for Q. Here we go. Number zero, behind the back. A little spin. He falls. Tony grabbed it. To three, three with a drive, block.
Lord, this Rams defense is angry.
Rejected. Number 20 gets the ball, spin by five. Five with the drive, and it fouled. And that'll. And out will come Q for Jackson. Jackson's been battling the foul bug tonight. And now Magnolia's in the bonus for the 1 minute and 52 seconds.
Question
left.
Is, will Magnolia hit these? They haven't been fortunate on free throws tonight, Dylan.
First shot is in. Well, unfortunately for Magnolia, these free throws are being hit at a later time than they need to.
Sinks them both.
He made both. Maybe he should have taken all the free throws tonight. They got to get it across. Axel running and.
Man, constantly foul. A whistle blown. This third quarter is.
It's another foul on number three. I think, that's just a second. I thought I've seen him a couple of times. Jackson, is that to you?
Looks like Lakeside's going to try to set something up right here.
Emerson to Jackson. Carson, Bentley for three. Bang!
Top of the key! Bentley Gigerich. What a night he's had.
I said it during his intro. Deadly shooter.
Sniper.
Exactly.
Bop, bop!
The drive. Good defense by Carson.
So Magnolia coach in shock after that.
The coach, I mean, I think I've seen that reaction out
yes.
of him. Just many times they've shot free throws tonight. I mean, wow. Drive. Oh,
almost
just
deflected.
Over Q.
Whoa.
That's a dangerous shot with Q in the paint, but he got it off and he made it. It is 31-19. Emerson Ooh. With the drive and Q bobbled it. Little well. And with a little help from number four as well. Collins guarding up. They got 50 seconds left in the quarter for three.
Bang! Magnolia gets a three.
Spot shooter. Q with the drive and a walk. He took an unfortunate little hike up to the Hot Springs Mountain Tower. Number zero with the ball. He drives. Couldn't find anything. Number three got a man behind him in the corner. He's just trying to force it. Number 20 for three.
Yeah. Playing great defense right there.
6 seconds. Now, Collins looking for a three.
Ooh.
Just over.
It was a Collins look like Superman right there.
Nice dive for good measure.
Would have been crazy if he sinked it.
Well.
Mandon, if you're the Magnolia coach right now, what do you say to these players right now?
I think you're telling them, we're within striking distance. You got a whole quarter left. They just got to start hitting. They're constantly getting free throws, so that's huge in the honestly, like, they make these free throws, they're back in the game. So you got a combination of free throws. If they can start hitting those corner threes, they had two last quarter that they were wide open for. If they can hit those are big. That's an addition of 6 points, and they're down by three.
I obviously continue to press because if Lakeside just has, if they don't press right there and Lakeside just throwing it around what they're known for, I mean, they're just going to, the clock's just going to tick away down when it gets down to zero.
Precious time gets wasted by Magnolia letting Lakeside get comfortable in their offense. They have to press. They have to get more 10-second violations, you know. It's just a matter of can they execute a press that puts Lakeside in a predicament where they're not going to continue.
Now, Lakeside right here on offense is probably going to be slow, methodical, probably going to 2 o'clock a little bit since it's a shot clock.
Yeah, for sure. 2 o'clock. For Lakeside right now, you got this. The game is in your favor. It's been since those two steals in the first quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let it slip away.
Yep. Gotta keep your foot on your neck.
Great defense by Emerson. Good drive. Q over the back and one. And now, that's not how you start.
It's this. This can put Magnolia right back into this.
Well, like I said, one of the things, if I'm the coach, I'm saying is we got to hit the free throws. Mm-hmm. Here's one.
Mm-hmm.
And he will just off the front.
It's like Magnolia pressing like
it will
predicted.
Remain a 7-point game. Emerson, move. And here we go. Lakeside's in their offense that they want to be in. They can waste time if they'd like. They could shoot if they like.
This is not where Magnolia wants to be right now.
Q, look at the drive. Does not. Gives it to Carson. Carson to Axel. Axel to Bentley for three. No, he does not take it.
Axel
for three. Just off.
Almost hits it.
Pass. Number zero. Zero with the ball to three. Three with the drive. Pass it to five. Number 20 for three. Dot just off the door. And it'll be off of number five.
Gonna be Lakeside's ball right here.
Well, I'm not trying to get on to the refs or anything, but I thought that was off cue.
Yeah.
Emerson. Driving up. 7-point game. Magnolia's got to get into this. Lobs to Q. Oh, foul. Q is obviously happy about that one. Looking at the scoring tonight, Q's got 9, Bentley's got 10, Axel's got 6, and 1 for Emerson. To go to double digits. It's good.
Skadoosh! Love to see if Q can go to hit both of these right here. It'd be huge for him.
Huge for his free throw confidence and huge to go up 9. And that second free throw is, just off. Bentley almost got the rebound.
Yeah.
He saves it. Pass up to number 3. They got numbers blocked by Jack. Wow.
Ooh, deep three.
Just off.
Dylan, if Bentley Gingrich hits that 3 right there, nail on the coffin. Boom.
Well, now they got another shot with a travel.
Mm-hmm.
It's a dagger time. Emerson. To Bentley. Bentley looking.
Ooh.
Emerson for 3. Is this the dagger?
Oh.
Just off.
Great rebound.
Axel with the rebound and it's fouled. Axel, he shot the technical free throws. He only went 1 for 2 from the line. There he will now hit that one. He's 2 for 3. In comes Avery for Carson. Avery coming in on 4 fouls. Can't foul again or he
Avery
is out.
Avery McBride just had a great defensive performance this whole game, just hacking balls left and right.
Oh, Axel almost got his rebound. 4 drives. Good shot. And it'll be a foul. On who? It'll be a foul on...
Is it Bentley?
It'll be a foul on Avery, and that's it for him. That's foul number 5. Honestly, I didn't think that was a foul on Avery. I thought it was a foul on...
On Bentley. Bentley was gone.
But no matter who it is, you got to know your player. You got to know your teammates on 4 fouls. You got to put your hand up. Got to put your hand up, say, all right, that was on me. Can't let him get fouled out.
By far. I mean, Magnolia is still in this.
I just missed. Down by 8. Can Magnolia stop?
Wide open.
Great pass to Axel. Axel drives. Fouled.
And Axel Jansky was just wide open right there. It just seemed like confusion on Magnolia, clearly.
Well, sometimes, I mean, the press works, but once you, when you figure it out, it's not very effective. Axel put Lakeside up by 9. He is good. Coach again barking at the refs. For Magnolia.
Yep.
Number 4 tries to go. Oh, he lost it. Q's got it, and it'll be
great hustle by Q Jackson diving on that ball.
A foul?
So Magnolia?
Oh, no. It was a timeout by Lakeside. The coach, again, a little frustrated. But.
Lakeside slowly pulling away from this game. Because Magnolia just continues to foul, and they get either 1 or 2 free throws.
1 more 3, lights out. I mean, good night, you know. It's time for this game to be put to bed.
Yes, by far.
Quick timeout. Lakeside's back at it. Emerson to Q.
Q
Q back to Emerson, the press. Like,
Q was blocking right there. Yep.
And they got it looks, and they can just hold it.
Looks like Lakeside's just going to hold the ball right here. Just 2 o'clock.
Axel to Bentley. Carson. Carson dribbling around, gives the Q. Q to Emerson. Well, like I like to say, there's no shot clock. So why shoot the ball?
Exactly.
Just keep it. Oh,
here
stolen.
We go.
And Q.
Rejected.
Oh, great job. And the follow back. Now it is again 7-point game.
That was a great block by Q, but unfortunately just Magnolia.
Great defense by Q. Way to not foul as well.
Unfortunately, Magnolia player just right there. Put it back up.
Now LeBron did that this week. He got a chase down block. Guy came in and dunked it.
Yep.
Poor LeBron. Axel to Q. Oh, fumbled by Q. Oh, it gets it back. Good move to Axel. To Bentley for three.
Another one. Oh.
And now, here we go.
Would have been another three for Bentley Gigrich.
Magnolia has a chance. For three. Bang.
Bang. Here we go. Wow, Magnolia still in this right now.
Now it's a 4-point game. Lakeside. Right here, you have to score.
By far.
Q to Axel. Axel to Bentley.
Shock. Magnolia hasn't fouled yet.
Man, if Magnolia had made more of those early in the game, they're up.
Man.
And there's a whistle called. It's a foul. It was a foul in the lane. It was off the ball. It'll be Magnolia's fourth. And now Lakeside is one foul away from the bonus. Couple subs for Magnolia. 10 and 5 come in for 22 and 20.
Great
he gets
pass.
A two.
Oh! Dylan, that almost was his third and one.
And that was almost the game. I mean, wow.
Q needs to hit these right here.
He's got free throws, which I say if I'm Magnolia, I'd rather the free throws than him get an and one opportunity.
Yeah.
Q's first one is just off. Man, no help from the rim there. Q, free throw is off.
This is
and
both of them.
Over the zero gets the ball. The pass up the five, and the layup is no good.
Magnolia needs a
now
foul
they, now
right
they got
here.
A fast break opportunity. Pass to Axel. To Bentley. Oh. That a three from Bentley would have sealed it there. But now they got to go. Oh. Almost stolen.
Q looks like he's just going to hold the ball.
Q's got strong hands. Oh. Pass over to Q. To Emerson. He can hold this one. They got a foul.
Are they... Magnolia's just not fouling, it looks like.
Don't foul.
There we go.
Man, and they let it get to the one person you don't want to foul. There's a reason he
takes Magnolia just missed their opportunity on that layup. If they hit that, it's just they're down by two.
And if Axel misses one, they're golden.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But there's a reason Axel takes the technical free throws.
I think Magnolia took a little too long.
Way
to
too
foul
long.
Them.
Well, they fouled the wrong person, too. Oh.
Oh, well.
Well, he missed.
Maybe. Maybe not.
Well, here we go. Axel, put him up by five.
Has to hit this.
His free throw is good.
All right. Magnolia either has to get a quick bucket right here or three.
Number zero to number three. And it's stolen by
defense.
Axel. Now Belly's got it. And a foul.
So Lakeside bench is getting hyped up.
Lakeside's bench is hyped up, and the coach is fired up over on the other side. Yeah, the coach is frustrated with the ref.
Parents are even getting into this.
Yeah, the coach is having some words. I think I'm not amazing at lip reading, but I think I saw something about a timeout. I think he was trying to call one.
Now, Lakeside, Magnolia's going to have a foul right here.
Definitely.
They're going to have to either foul Q or Q. Probably going to have to foul Q right here.
It's much needed. There's 30 seconds left in this timeout, and this has got to be nerve-wracking for Lakeside. Look, two free throws and the game. One for two, game's alive.
Mm-hmm. By fault.
Magnolia, wow. Wait to make it a game. I mean, from those two steals, I just continuously go back to them. Those two steals in the first quarter, and up until this quarter, that Lakeside has control. Magnolia is finally finding it. So fortunately, I think it's not at the right time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, Magnolia, if they can get an inbound stop, that'd be big too.
So
no foul, and there's the foul.
Yeah.
That's a precious 0.5 that they kept on, that they left on. I mean, they didn't foul them immediately.
It's like Lakeside's gonna play back, obviously.
Emerson's gonna be all alone for his two free throws. Two huge free throws for Emerson. Emerson's first shot is good.
Dang.
Emerson has not scored a lot of points. He's not shot a lot of shots.
Could this be the nail in the coffin?
Emerson. Missed. Now Magnolia's got a chance. I would go quick. And a travel. Wow.
And Dylan.
Good defense by Lakeside.
I think Lakeside might walk away with this.
And a foul cue.
Probably the most likely person to foul right there.
And a tech for the coach.
He's out of here.
Hey, I'm gonna put this out there. How has he not already gotten a tech?
He's been like this since second quarter.
I was watching the eighth grade game. He was out on the logo at points. My goodness.
Yeah, kind of like Eric Musselman.
He's entertaining, though. I will give him that. He's a great guy. He's a funny coach. Mm. Oh, just off the front for Q. He's very entertaining, coach. I've liked watching him. Q's second free throw is no good.
Yeah, by far a great coach. Bring this team back by 10. Play them in this situation right here.
Well, and now Bentley will take the technical free throws, and I believe Lakeside gets the ball after this. Bentley's first free throw
looks
is
like
good.
Emerson's talking down there to one of the Magnolia players.
He's talking about
a little trash.
And he made it to both. Up by 8. Bentley's got 12. Lakeside has the ball. Bentley open and fouled.
Yeah.
Bentley to end the game. Makes the first.
Yep. And it looks like Lakeside is going to walk away with the victory.
Good night to Magnolia. And Bentley makes both. 14 for him. Solid day for Giegerich. For three. Just off the front, and that'll be game.
Looks like Magnolia's still trying to foul. 22 thinks Magnolia still has a shot at winning this.
That was interesting. And a three. Oh.
No good.
I don't know how that almost went in, and that is the game. Lakeside wins 40-30.
Great win by Lakeside, containing the number one seed and getting conference champions. I can see Magnolia and Lakeside facing each other again in the playoffs.
Most definitely could.
Either semis or championship.
Magnolia, good fight. They tried. But at the end of the day, they ended up losing by 10. Unfortunate, but they played a heck of a game.
And Lakeside figured out their offense clearly this game, Dylan.
Man, much better than Sheridan.
Threes all over the place.
Oh, my gosh, yes. Jackson started it. Bentley got it. Well, it was a great game. God bless.
And go Rams!